The first question is from ranking. A is 14th from the left end in a row of boys and B is 10th from the right end. C is 10th to the right of A and 4th to the right of B. How many boys are there in the row? Okay, so how do you solve this? See, to solve this question, if you find the positions of the persons given, it will become very easy. That is the smart way of approaching this question. So what is given here? A is 14th from the left end of the row. So if this is A, what is the position of A? A is 14th from the left end, from this end. A is 14th. Then what are they saying of boys? And B is 10th from the right end. So what is the position of B from this end? B is 10th from the right end. Now, next, what are they saying? C is 10th to the right of A and 4th to the right of B. So I can very clearly say that if this is the total number of students, this has to be C. C has to be somewhere here. Why? Because we know that C is to the right of A and it is also to the right of B. Now, what is given about the position of C? It is given that C is 10th to the right of A. So what will be the position of C from the left end? See, this is your left end and this is your right end. Now, what is the position of C from the left end? See, A's position is 14th from the left end and it is given C is 10th to the right of A. So C's position from the left end is going to be 24th. Correct? C's position from the left end is going to be 24th because A is 14th, then C is 10 positions after that. So C is going to be 24th from the left end. Then what is given about, another information about C is given is that it is 4th to the right of B. So 4th to the right of B means what will be the position of B from the left end? See, C is 4th to the right of B means the position of B from the left end has to be 20th. Okay, now what do I have? See, I have the position of B from the left end and from the right end. Now, in any line, okay, let us, if you take any line, if you know the position of a person from the left end and the right end, then you can say that the number of people in the line is given as L plus R minus 1. Apply this very basic formula here. So, what will you get? You will get 20 plus 10 minus 1. That is equal to 29. See, I know the position of B from the left end and from the right end. This is the position of B from the left end. This is the position of B from the right end. Now, if I know this directly, I put it in formula 20 plus 10 minus 1, or there will be 29 people. Now, how many boys are there in the row? Options, none of the options match. So the answer here will be none of these. Okay, generally when we have questions on ranking, in many questions I tell you to see how many people are there before a given person and then solve, right? But in this particular question, this is the best way in which you can approach, where you have very less calculations and you can arrive at the answer really faster. Okay, the normal way in which we do, if we see what is the position, that is how many people are there before A, how many people are there between A and B. If we follow this method, the normal method that we use, it will be more time consuming. So this would be the faster way to approach the question. Just take the position of the people from the left end and the right end, and you are able to freeze the position of B from the left end and from the right end. From that, you are finding the total number of people in the row.
In a class of 39 students, the ratio of boys and girls is 2:1. So immediately you should know that there are 26 boys and 13 girls, right? 26 boys and 13 girls. 26 plus 13 is 39, and 26 is 13 is 2:1, right? Then Akruti ranks 15 among all the students from top and 8th among girls from the bottom. How many boys are there below Akruti? Interesting one, right? Akruti ranks 15th among all the students. 15th among all the students from top and 8th among girls from the bottom. 8th among girls from the bottom. Right? Now try and understand. First of all, Akruti is 15th from top. So Akruti's rank from bottom. What is Akruti's rank from bottom? Total 39 minus 15 plus 1. You know this logic, right? I mean, we have explained this in the ranking video. How to find the position from the other end. Total number of persons minus the position from the one end plus 1. So 39 minus 15 plus 1 will give you what? Akruti's position from bottom, right? Akruti's position from bottom. So how much is it? 40 minus 15, 25th. Basically, Akruti's 25th from bottom. Akruti's 25th from bottom. She is 13th from top and 25th from bottom. Now, it says she's 8 among girls from bottom. 8 among girls from bottom. How many boys are there below Akriti? Try and understand, if you arrange all these persons in based on the ranks, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, 25, 26, and so on, up to 38, 39. Right? What happens? Akriti comes here. Achha, Akriti is 25th from bottom, right? Akriti is 25th from bottom, be careful. Or Akriti is 15th from top, right? So Akriti comes here. This is Akriti's position. Right? So if Akriti is 25th from bottom, how many persons are there below Akriti? Or same way, there is 15th from top or 25th from bottom. If I say 1, 2, 3 and so on, this will be 25th. And so on, this will be 39th, right? So basically, there are 24 persons below Akriti, 24 students. You don't have to do all this in the exam, by the way. I'm just trying to explain it to you clearly, right? 24 students below Akriti. You're able to follow 24 students below Akriti because Akriti is 25th from bottom. 25th from bottom. So below Akriti, there are 24 students. And we also know that Akriti is 8th among girls from bottom. Akriti is the 8th girl from bottom. Remember, 8th girl. 8th girl is Akriti from bottom. This is 25th student from bottom or 8th girl from bottom. 25th student or 8th girl from bottom. Akriti is the 8th girl from bottom. Which means there are 7 girls below Akriti. You don't have to write this. This is just to understand, right? I mean, this is a mental calculation, right? There are 7 girls below Akriti. Right or not? Akriti is 25th student from bottom. So there are 24 students below Akriti. Akriti is 8th girl from bottom. So there are 7 girls below Akriti. The question is, how many boys are there below Akriti? Now, number of boys below Akriti. Total 24 students are there below Akriti, of which 7 are girls. Out of these 24, 7 are girls. So, number of boys below Akriti will be what? 24 minus 7, which is 17. So, 17 is the correct answer. It doesn't take so much time for you to solve it in the exam. I am explaining this to you in detail. And that's the reason it has taken, you know, this much. And you don't really have to write all this on paper, right? Don't do all this. Find out Akriti's rank from bottom. It comes out to be 25th. Akriti is 25th from bottom, meaning 24 students are below Akriti. And 7 girls are below Akriti. So, 24 minus 7, 17 boys are below Akriti. 17 is the final answer.